Okay, in this section, let me show you how you can use the Notion Web Clipper or Save to Notion. This is a very, you want to use that, you want to set up that, because by using that, you can just easily press a button and add things from the web, like YouTube video or article, blog, whatever, bookmark, and add directly to the second brain, okay? You have two options. Show you the first option is to use Notion Web Clipper. I have it here. You can find Notion Web Clipper. There is the link in the template as well. You can install for Chrome, Safari, or Firefox. Let's say that I install. As I already have installed, you're going to find that this is the icon. If you don't find, you usually want to go to your extension and pin that, right? And you can do the same from Save to Notion. Click Save to Notion, you're going to find this extension. You can download for Chrome and you can install as well. And this will be the Notion saver. Okay, let me show you how that works, how you can capture information from the web. So let's go to my favorite website ever. This is the best website ever. This is my Notion Avenue website. And I'm going to go to blog. Okay, let me find an article, or I'm going to find how to save pages templates in Notion. And let's say that we want to save these to our resource. That will be our bookmark, basically. Everything that is from the web is going to go into the resource database. So I click this. Perfect. So you say, let me save this page. So the thing that you need to do is to set up this. And as you set up this, this is going to become the default setting. So add2 will be the database and workspace will be the workspace. Of course, be sure to find the current workspace. And then you're going to find the database. So the database, you're going to find database going to call resources. Okay. Right now is called resource current. As I already explained, it's just a way from the way that I manage all my second brain, all my template to find the correct database. But you're going to find that call like resources, and you see that it will be like going to tell you a bit where is this database. So second brain and inside para. So this should be the only one. If you have multiple, be sure to connect to the right one. So I click here, and then I just need to save the page. So I just clip a page from the web to Notion, and I'm going to go to where the resources are, right? So to go to the resources are, I can just navigate here, para, because our resources are inside the para method, so the para system. And I scroll down, I'm going to show you this in a bit. There is resource, and the first database is actually our bookmark database. If I just go show database title is the database that we saved, right? And as we done things correctly, we should have saved this page to our resource. So I can open it up. Okay. And as you can see, when you use a Save to Notion and there is an article, there is content, Notion will save the article inside the database. So it's not just a bookmark. There is content in it. You can see there is, I have everything that I have on this page. It's run in this page. And this will become relevant when I talk about how to build actually the second brain, how to connect that, how to, you know, organize your knowledge. And we can save like this YouTube video. So you will find that Notion saved the embed version of the YouTube video inside that. We can try if you want. I can try so I can show you how that work. So let's say Notion. Let's find something about Notion. This is relevant.
Hi, okay. I'm I.
Okay, so I can do the same thing. I can click Save to Notion and I save the page. Perfect. I can also click here to just open in Notion directly, right? So it's going to open. And you can see how I have inside this the an embed version of the YouTube video. Let's see Save to Notion, the extension, okay? It do have some more feature, but it also is an external software and an external extension, and I recently noticed that they have like they make you pay for such a feature, of course. So it's really dependent on how you're using that. And let's use Save to Notion. So you see that Save to Notion has forms, and basically what that the main thing that is different, right, is that you can have multiple destination for different different source from the web. So maybe you want to add all your, I don't know, YouTube video in a specific database or things like that. You may do that. Like, for example, I have different form, and basically these are database, right? And of course there are some features are locked, and but the way that it's going to work, so I think that I cannot add a new because they told me that I need to upgrade. So let's change one. So let's assume that we don't have this and just add a new form. So as we done before, we need to select database, right? We need to be sure to be in the current space. Right now we are not in the current workspace. So let's move to this workspace when there is a second brain. And then I'm going to just, of course, it's just popping up here, but I can do this to find, and this is the template, the database. So we click, and there is more basically customization option that you can have. But right now it's, don't need to do that. Don't need to know. I'm going to create maybe another video, another tutorial for how to use Save to Notion. But this is how you do. You save and go back. Okay. Actually, what we need to do here, we need to say what is the content. And right now, the content will be saved as bookmark. Instead, we want to do embed web in Notion page. So this is going, Notion do that by default. In Save to Notion, you need to say that you want the content of the page to be the web page content to clip that as Notion web clipper already do. So save. And so right now what we do is basically we just click here and we do save. We have done the same things basically, but with this other extension.